If this is our hypothesis, we now must devise an experiment to further refine this hypothesis. Let's come up with a very simple input where we would assume that this holds. If we put in just foo in double quotes without any tags, we would assume that we would get the very same output. Let's do this as an experiment. Here again, we have our buggy function, and now let's conduct the experiment. So we invoke print.html markup with foo and close in double quotes. We press run, and the output is foo without double quotes. So now we see the output is not what we expected, the output being foo without quotes, and this again confirms our hypothesis. We can try this out with even more strings, further strengthening our hypothesis. So if we put in bar, not very surprising, what's going to happen? We get bar as output. And if we put in just the two quotes, what we get is an empty string. So we get more failures down the way. This hypothesis is confirmed now by a number of experiments. Double quotes are stripped from tagged input. But actually, we didn't even have any tags, so we can actually scratch that. Double quotes are stripped from general input. So even if there's no tags, quotes are being stripped away. Now we can actually go and explore the cause-effect chain. If quotes are being stripped away, there must be a place in the code which does that. The only place in our code where quotes are handled, right here in this line. Here we have, if there is a double quote or a single quote and tag is being set, then quote should be inverted. And when quote is inverted, tags should not be recognized. Nothing too complicated, but why would the quotes be stripped? Because normally we should not be in tag mode. Maybe we are in tag mode. Maybe the variable tag is set. So we can come up with a new hypothesis that explains precisely that.